Hey everyone, welcome back to Slide Uplift. Today we're going to learn how to create a really awesome new morphic PowerPoint template. It's going to look super professional, and it's easier than you think. To save time, you can even download this template using the link in the description. Use the code in the description for an extra 10% off, or if you'd like to do it yourself, keep watching. First things first, open a blank slide. Go to Format Background and select Solid Fill. Click on Custom and enter the hex code. E8ECF0 to set the background color. Next, insert a circle by going to Insert, Shapes, and then Circle. Remove the outline by clicking Shape Outline and setting it to No Outline. Fill the circle with the same background color. Now right-click the circle, select Format Shape, and go to the Effects section. Apply a shadow effect. Set the preset to your choice. Go to More Colors. Enter the hex code ACB0C0 and customize the transparency, distance, and blur settings. Then, duplicate the circle by holding Ctrl and dragging it. Apply another shadow effect to the duplicate and set the preset to the top left and the shadow color to white. Adjust the transparency to 25%. Blur to 20%, and distance to 10%. Next, align the circles by selecting both, going to Align, and centering them. Group them using Ctrl plus G. Duplicate the group with Ctrl plus D, and resize them as needed to fit the slide layout. Then adjust the shape as you need it. Then duplicate the shape. Ungroup one circle set and delete the top circle. Right-click the remaining circle. Go to Format Shape and apply another shadow. Select from the preset options. For this one, adjust transparency to 40%, blur to 15%, and distance to 10%. Then go to Fill in Line and apply a gradient fill, removing extra stops in the gradient bar. Set one gradient stop to icy blue and the other to white. Adjust the gradient's angle and direction. Adjust the gradient as you need it. Align the shape and send it to back. Next, add a text box by going to Insert and Text Box. Type your content. Adjust the font, size, and alignment, and format it as bold. Duplicate the text box for additional content. Add the content. Adjust the content and change the color. And bring it to front. Align them. Now let's just create some rounded rectangles. First, Duplicate the group circles and resize them. Add a rounded rectangle beneath the circle group. And type your header and description text. Format the text. And align it with the rectangles. Duplicate and align the rectangles as needed. Next, add the remaining text. Now add circle shape for icon. Duplicate them. Insert icons by going to Insert, Pictures, and then click on This Device. Convert the icons to shapes. Resize them. Align the icons to their respective circles. And change their color to dark blue. Do this same all three slide. Now for the final touch, let's add the magic with the most fascinating step, the animation. For the title circle, apply a wipe animation from the Exit Animations list. Change the width and color. Duplicate the line and adjust it. Change the color of shape as you like it. Change the color of icon. Now let's add color. Now add fade animation and adjust the duration. For the title circle, apply a wipe animation from the Exit Animations list. Set the start to with previous, duration to 1 second, and delay time to 1.25 seconds. For animating the curved lines, apply a wipe animation with the same settings and trigger it to group 14. Copy the animation using Animation Painter and apply it to the other lines. For adding animation to the icon circles, apply a line animation from the Motion Path section. Adjust the red dot of the animation path to connect with the rounded rectangle. Trigger the animation to group 14 and adjust the duration and delay as needed. Repeat this to rest of the slide. For adding animation to the header and description text, apply a fade animation with a start of with previous. Duration of 1.5 seconds and delay time of 3 seconds. Test the slideshow to ensure all animations are functioning correctly. Adjust trigger points, timings, or layering as necessary. And there you have it. A fully functional, interactive, pneumorphic template in PowerPoint. Check out the link in the description to download the template now. If you found this video helpful, don't forget to like, share, and subscribe to Slide Uplift. Hit that bell icon to get notified for our next video. You can check out our channel for more PowerPoint tutorials.